5 houseplants that are oxygen bombs to keep the air within your house clean.
1. Bamboo palm.
The bamboo palm, also known as reed palm, is a good-looking addition to any kind of space. It looks good next to furniture, especially the ones that are more prone to emitting the toxins we are trying to curb, as well as by itself. It is a nice touch of tropical freshness to transform any kind of living space ranging from public lobbies to a private study. These plants helps remove toxic compounds like toluene, which is mostly found in building materials, lubricant, grease and tobacco smoke, benzene and formaldehyde. 2. Florist's chrysanthemum. These flowers look very showy. The plant isn't as tolerant of neglect and abuse as the ones mentioned above, but their presence makes them worth the trouble. These flowers come in a variety of colors. These plants are very common, inexpensive and perennial. The florist chrysanthemums have the ability to filter organic chemicals from air like formaldehyde, benzene, trichloroethylene. Another additional publication, Wolverton and Wolverton, 1993, found that chrysanthemums were able to filter ammonia and xylene from the air too. 3. Snake plant or mother-in-law's tongue. These are one of the hardiest indoor plants to kill. The snake plant is tolerant of low lighting, unsuitable growing conditions and literally any kind of neglect. It has interesting foliage and is one of those plants that release oxygen even during the night time, hence, this is a good fixture for bedrooms. Snake plants not only add an interesting texture to home spaces but also release water vapor while releasing oxygen and help keep the air cool and fresh feeling, which makes them a good specimen to have in tropical environments. The moisture released by these plants help lessens airborne allergens. The study farther revealed that the Sansevieria effectively removes from air formaldehyde, xylene, toluene and nitrogen oxides. Industries and workspaces such as automotive plants and shops, aircraft plants, plywood, carpeting, paint makers and sellers, printing, and offices, where these toxic pollutant are released in excessive amount would substantially benefit from planting a lot snake plants around the vicinity. 4. Peace lily, spathiphyllum. These are also known as closet plants. They are very popularly used in offices and homes. Peace lilies are easy to care for, easiest among the most indoor plants, however, proper growing conditions are still important for them. They curb molds and hence make for good additions in the bathrooms and wet spaces. Peace lily has been found to efficiently remove benzene and trichloroethylene commonly found in varnish, lacquer and paints. They absorb these harmful chemicals through their leaves, which is transported to the roots to be broken down by the microbes in the soil. The major downside of the peace lily is that ingesting some parts of it could be mildly toxic. Upon ingestion, one can feel nauseous, experience some difficulties in swallowing and feel a sensation of burning on the skin or inside of the mouth. If such symptoms appear, it is better to opt for immediate medical attention. Keeping away pets from this plant is also crucial, and last but not the least, English ivy, Hetera helix. The common ivy is an ornamental plant widely used to cover walls. It cools the interiors in summers and insulates in winters. For domestic purposes, it is best to grow them in pots to keep them from either invading other plants or causing structural damage to the walls if left to grow uninterrupted. It is also low maintenance and flexible with respect to growing conditions. Apart from its toxin eradication benefits, the English ivy is also capable of removing more than 58% feces particles along with 60% of air toxins only within 6 hours. The list, too, includes other plants that remove just one or two of the toxins mentioned above. The list presented here mentions plants that remove all or at least 4 of them. Note: some of the plants mentioned might be toxic to pets. So, if you intend on getting one of these, it would be a good idea to check that detail out beforehand. The recommended count of these plants is 1 plant every 100 square feet, every 10 square meter. Thank you and goodbye for now. See you on my next video.